Ladies and gentlemen, Snapshot 22w11a is the first snapshot for Minecraft 1.19 and includes a fair bit of technical news for resource packs, tags, custom world generation, and much more. My name is slicedlime and I am here to take you through all the technical changes. If you're looking for the gameplay changes in the snapshot, check out the video linked right here, it's got all the details for you. Let's start with the pack format for both resource and the data packs. The data pack version is now number 10. And the resource pack version is now 9. You'll need to update that number in pack.mc meta for your pack to not show up as out of date when adding it in game. Another new feature in the pack.mc meta file is that they can now have a filter section. When present, this section must have a block field with a list of patterns for namespaces and paths. Each such pattern is matched against all files in data packs lower down in the stack, and if the file name or namespace pattern matches, then that file is excluded, which means the game considers that file to not be present at all. The filter section does not apply to your pack, only to packs below it. Both the namespace and path fields can be omitted, and if they are, the game works as if they had been specified as .star. When they are included, these fields contain a regular expression pattern. Before we get into a lot of other details, a number of new blocks, items, and entities were added in this version. I will not be mentioning the files related to these in the rest of this video. Let's talk about some specifics for resource packs. A fix has been done to the texture mapping of both types of spider mobs, and for the ears of wolves. These changes are barely visible in vanilla, but make the mirroring work properly for resource packs. Some unused pixels have been removed from the end-rod texture, which doesn't matter if you have that texture overridden, but might be good to know if you're looking at what files changed. In addition, the texture mapping of the second growth stage of cocoa beans have changed in a way that will break all custom textures, and the texture mapping of brewing stands and all types of doors have changed in a way that might or might not break custom textures. Let's talk about commands. A fix has been made for the rendering of boss bars, which now have the correct appearance even when several boss bars with the notched style are visible at once. There's some new functionality for text as well. Fonts now have a space glyph provider with a single advances argument, which maps code points to how much the text rendering point is moved by that code point, which makes custom space widths available, including negative spacing. A single change in the format of predicates in this version. The location predicate field feature has been renamed to structure. There are quite a lot of news for tags in this version. We can start with added block tags. Dragon Transparent controls the blocks the Ender Dragon cannot destroy, but will instead fly straight through. In addition, there are a number of block tags relating to the new gameplay things in this update. Mangrove Logs, Convertible to Mud, Frog Prefer Jump 2, Skulk Replaceable, and Skulk Replaceable World Gen. Mangrove Logs also exists as a new item tag. There are many new biome tags in this version. Let's start with some that just categorize biomes. Is Overworld, is End, and is Savannah. The Has Structure slash Stronghold tag now includes the Is Overworld tag, and the previous content of that tag is now instead found in a new biome tag called Stronghold Biased 2. Another structure-related biome tag is Required Ocean Monument Surrounding, for biomes that must be present around a location for a monument to be possible there. This version also adds plenty of spawning-related biome tags. Their purpose should be mostly self-evident from their names. Allows surface slime spawns, allows tropical fish spawns at any height, more frequent drowned spawns, polar bears spawn on alternate blocks, reduced water ambient spawns, without patrol spawns, without wandering trader spawns, and without zombie sieges. One special one to mention is the polar bears spawn on alternate blocks, which is also related to a block tag which has been renamed. Polar bears spawnable on in frozen ocean is now called polar bears spawnable on alternate. Other new biome tags control which variants of various mobs spawn in different biomes. Only allows snow and gold rabbits, spawns cold variant frogs, and spawns warm variant frogs. Some other new biome tags control other aspects of gameplay, including has closer water fog for the shorter view distance underwater present in swamps by default, plays underwater music for biomes that play the special underwater music when the player is underwater, produces coral from bone meal for biomes where coral can be farmed, and water on map outlines for biomes that show up as water on map outlines, which means things like buried treasure maps and explorer maps. Structure tags have moved from configured structure feature to structure. We'll talk more about this in the custom world news later. There are also two new structure tags, cats spawn in and cats spawn as black, both controlling the cat spawning and both containing only witch huts by default. There are also new tag types for world presets and flat world presets. We'll talk more about them later when we talk about custom world presets. Let's move on to particle news. There are three new particle types in this version: Skulk Souls, Skulk Charge Pops, and Skulk Charge, which currently is not usable from commands. A new server property has been added in this version: Max Chained Neighbor Updates, which control the amount of consecutive neighbor updates before skipping additional ones. Negative values remove the limit. Blending works with 3D biomes in this version, so underground blending now also works. The blending data field for chunk data no longer has an old noise field. This is now instead determined based on the presence of the blending data itself. Blending data now also has min section and max section fields, which are used to determine which range of world data to consider old and thus blend. Let's talk about world presets, which can now be customized using data packs. A world preset is a map of dimension IDs to generation settings, and all dimensions in a preset will be generated when a new world is created using that preset. There are also two tags for world presets: Normal and Extended. They control what presets show up as you click through the different options in the Create World screen, and in which order. The Extended tag is what shows up when you hold down the Alt key, which includes the Debug Mode preset by default. A custom world preset can also now be specified in the Level Type field of server.properties while creating a new world for a server. Flat world presets can now also be customized. These are the options that show up when creating a flat world. A preset file is a list of layers, a structure override section with a custom set of structures to generate, the biome to use for the world, and some miscellaneous settings. It also has a display field with an item ID, which is used as an icon for the preset in the user interface. There's also a tag for these called Visible, which controls all the visible presets in the user interface and also their order. Before we move into custom worlds, I'd like to take a brief moment to ask you to use the like button preset for this video. Liking the video makes YouTube more likely to suggest it to others, so I'd really appreciate your help. Thank you. Let's talk custom worlds, and there's so many custom world changes that I'm going to split this into multiple sections. For an overview, the dimension folder is no longer present in the vanilla world generation reference pack, but dimension files still work like they used to inside a custom data pack. There's also a new file type that the data report generator can output in the biome parameters folder, containing all the biome parameters for the default vanilla dimensions. Another dimension-related change in this version is that custom dimensions no longer require a separate seed field, and in fact can no longer have a custom seed. The world seed is now always used for all dimensions. One change in the noise settings. It now has a spawn target field with climate parameters to try to optimize when finding a suitable place for the world spawn. Let's talk about biomes. Biome definition files no longer have a category field. Biome categories have been completely removed, and all the functionality that was tied to that is now controlled by all those biome tags we went through in the tags section. One tiny change is that the H for humidity on the debug screen has been changed to a V for vegetation. In density function news, the terrain shaper field has been removed from noise settings, and that functionality is now instead used from regular cubic spline density functions. The special case terrain shaper spline type has been removed. In feature news, a new Skulk patch configured feature type has been added with a number of exposed fields relating to Skulk spread. The glow lichen feature now also has a block field that references a multi-phase block. This version also has some big changes to structures. Let's start with a simple one. The structure block user interface now has more space for long structure names. In terms of placement, structure sets now have a frequency field, which is used instead of a probability in the structure itself to control how many of the locations actually get a structure. There's also an optional frequency reduction method field that can be set to legacy type 1, 2, or 3. This should never be needed for custom data, it's simply used to avoid existing structures moving. A new optional field called exclusion zone is also available, which can be used to make the structure set check for the existence of another structure set placement within a certain range, and if so, avoid placing nearby. Note that this is both expensive in terms of performance and can cause stability problems if you have several structures looking for each other. A better way of achieving the same type of result could be to have the same structure set place both structure types, like is done with the Nether complex structure set in the vanilla data. There are a few new fields for the concentric rings structure placement type too. It now also has a salt field and a new preferred biomes tag field. Structures themselves have also changed. They're now called structures rather than configured structure features, and the configuration is done directly in the JSON files rather than in a separate config field. This also means that the type field in mineshafts has changed names to mineshaft type to avoid clashing with the already existing type field in structures. All structures also have a new field called step, which controls when in the world generation process the structure gets generated. Ruined portals no longer have a portal type field. Instead, they now expose a bunch of configurability. Each ruined portal has a setups field, which is a weighted list of possible setups, each with a slew of settings. Finally, the Jigsaw-based structure types have now all been merged into one, which means villages, bastions, and pillager outposts now all have type Minecraft:Jigsaw. They also have new settings, which include start height, which is a height provider, and an optional project start to height map field, which, when present, contains a height map name. They also have a use expansion hack field that makes the bounding box get expanded a bit, which should not be needed for any custom content. And that's all the tech news in this version. Thank you very much for staying with me all the way to the end of the video, I really appreciate it. And if you're curious about the technical changes released recently in Minecraft 1.18.2, here's a great video for that, so go check it out.